you have problems paying attention to your surroundings? Is your office nickname Butterfingers? That's not a big deal, unless you love drinking coffee while working. Don't worry, today we're going to give you some great advice to help you be prepared for spilling doomsday. Being clumsy is a great risk factor, but the truth is that no matter how well coordinated you are, at some point in your life, you will spill some liquid on your keyboard. So let's see what we can do to give it a better chance of surviving. Tip number zero, be prepared. When spilling doomsday comes, it might be too late to learn how to disassemble your keyboard while dealing with the aftermath. You really want to learn how to do it before anything happens. If you own a Dygma Raise, you can check out this video on how to disassemble and reassemble your keyboard. We even have an iFixit guide. The link is in the description below. If you don't have a Dygma Raise, disassembling your keyboard can be a bit tricky. Start by locating the screws on the base, which some manufacturers hide under rubber legs or labels. Also, check if there's a guide on how to disassemble your specific keyboard model. Once you have that figured out, let's move on to the actual recommendations. Tip number one, hands up! When you spill liquids on your keyboard, please don't panic and start cleaning it with a cloth or your sleeve. By doing so, you might press the keys and make it easier for the liquid to get in contact with the electronics. Just leave things as they are and calmly proceed to our next tip. Tip 2, unplug your keyboard as soon as you can. That will stop the possibility of a short circuit that could damage the electronics. What is a short circuit? In any electronic circuit, electricity flows through different electronic components, such as the resistors, transistors, capacitors, etc., in a certain order. When liquid gets in contact with the circuit, it creates unintended shortcuts, which alter the order and can completely screw up the electronics of your keyboard. Tip 3. Dry the electronics. Disassemble the keyboard, put the plastic and mechanical parts aside, and focus on the electronics. If you've spilled water, the goal is to dry it ASAP. But don't just blow on the electronics. It's best to use a hairdryer. If you think it's dry, just leave it some more time. It's always a good idea to make sure there's no moisture before plugging it in again. If you've spilled other liquids, such as coffee, milk, or soda, you'll need to clean the electronics before they dry. We recommend using isopropyl alcohol, but ethyl alcohol at 96% will also work. And before you ask, no, gin or vodka won't work. Put some alcohol in a cloth, clean the parts and let them dry. Check all the switches and see if there's any liquid. If so, disassemble and clean them again. If you don't know how to open a mechanical switch, check out this other video where we explain it. Preventing damage to the electronic components is the main focus, but let's not forget about the rest of your keyboard. Tip 4, dry everything else. While your electronics are drying, let's move on to the keys, the panels, and any other parts. We recommend using a window cleaner. It dries quickly and leaves no trace on plastic or metal. However, if you've spilled something oily, first you need to clean it with dish soap and water. Then you can use the window cleaner to remove any soap or water. You can check all the details on how to clean your keyboard in this video. Again, leave everything to dry until you're 100% sure it's super dry. Then reassemble your keyboard and enjoy. Now that you've seen the consequences of spilling liquids on your keyboard, you might be thinking, how can I prevent this from happening again? Well, we're not going to tell you to stop having coffee or water. So until some anti-gravitational shield is invented, the next best thing would be raising your keyboard from the table with something like the tenting kit. Believe me, we've seen it save a couple of Dygma Raise keyboards from drowning in coffee. If you have stories about your own spilling doomsday or any other helpful advice, let us know in the comments section below. And remember that if you have a Dygma keyboard, our customer support team will be more than happy to help you with any kind of problem. Bye!